Good morning. Last class we discussed about in QTP we discussed about the keyword driven framework. Now here today we are going to discuss about the quality center test management tool which we are going to use. Can you tell some of the major activities during manual testing? What are the major activities we do during manual testing? What are the major activities? First you have to go for the so identify test scenarios, then we need to prepare test cases. Then we have to go for the execution of test cases. Then we can go for the defect reporting. Then make sure those defects has to be resolved by the developers, getting it fixed. Okay, this type of activities where we are going to perform, identify test scenarios, prepare test cases, execution of test cases, defect reporting, getting it fixed. In the same way, if I go for the automation testing, whatever tool we are going to use. So automation testing, what are the activities we are going to perform? First, we go for the identify automation test scenarios. We need to identify automation test scenarios. Then, based on the scenarios, we have to develop the automation test scripts. We have to develop the automation test scripts. Then, execution of test scripts. Next thing we have to go for, the once execution is completed, which is done by the tool, your tool is going to give the test result in terms of pass or fail. As a test engineer, we should analyze test result. Analyze test result. Based on that, we have to go for the defect reporting. And make sure those has to be resolved by the developers. So getting it fixed. So the major activities during manual testing and automation testing. But here, execution only we are not going to perform during automation testing. Your tool is going to perform. It can be Selenium or it can be QTP. Okay, tool is going to perform. Whenever execution is completed, we are going to get the test result in terms of pass or fail. We have to analyze the result to know that which functionalities are passed or which functionalities are failed. But then we have to analyze the result. Now, how the defect submission process is going to be, how the defect submission process, how it is going to be. So there are generally two types of protocols are followed based on the experience of the test engine. If suppose testing have the less than 3+ years of experience, whenever he identified defects, first he has to go for the preparing defect profile. What type of defect you identified? What is the priority? What is the severity? Reproducible defect or not? So reproducible steps, defect snapshot if required. This all the information to be provided. And that has to be sent to the test lead where he will do the review on your defect profile. If it is valid, then he's going to intimate to the reporting manager at development team. If suppose you have the 3+ years of experience, more than that, then as a test engineer, whenever you identify defect, you have to prepare the defect profile. And we can send one copy to the reporting manager directly and one copy to the test lead. That are the two types of protocols based on the experience. Less than 3+ years of experience and more than 3+ years of experience. But how these defects are going to report? For that, they can do manually or they can use defect reporting tool. Manually means there will be shared repository. We can upload Excel sheet, we are going to prepare the defect profile, we can upload into the shared repository, shared folder. From there, developers can access. But it is outdated, most of the companies know. So there are several tools are available for the defect reporting purpose. They can use any one of the tool for the defect report. Okay. Like Quality Center, Bugzilla, D-Tracker, G-Tracker, Jira, like this, various tools are available in the market. They can use any one of the two. That means as a test engineer, not only knowing the knowledge on manual testing and automation testing, you should have at least one tool knowledge for defect reporting purpose. It can be any tool. Defect reporting tools are not like Selenium, not like QTP to develop the scripts there. You have to know that how to operate it. Simple navigation. How we are going to use the Gmail application? How we are going to use the Yahoo Mail application? Same way. You should have login credentials. You have to use those things to operate your application. Here, we are going to discuss the leading defect reporting tool like Quality Center. Who developed this one? Is it licensed tool or free tool? So, Quality Center is licensed automation tool, which is developed by HP. HP product we are going to call. We have the different versions of the Quality Center. We'll see there what it is. Quality Center, it is a test management tool from Mercury Interactive, taken over by the HP. The primary intention of Quality Center is defect tracking. The major purpose, defect tracking. Earlier we discussed about the difference between defect reporting to the defect tracking. Defect reporting means notifying about the defects to developers is called defect reporting. Then what is the meaning of defect tracking? So not only fixed or not, we are going to maintain the defects information for a project. Maintenance about the defects information for a project. So who identified, when it is identified, so defects is reproducible or not, defect is resolved or not, so status of the defect, priority, severity, so these all things has to be maintained for your defects which are identified for your project. At any point of time, I want to know that specific test engineer, how many defects he identified, I want to know it. You can easily track when I go for the quality center. We have the database where we can store it, easily can track the information on ongoing project defects. That is the defect track, the primary intention. The earlier version of Quality Center was Test Director. We have the different versions in Quality Center earlier. It started with 5.0, 6.0, 7.0, 7.6 and 8.0. Up to this version, we have the name as Test Director. Then onwards, the name is changed as Quality Center. From 8.2, 9.0, 9.2 and 10.0, up to that the name is called Quality Center. After that again, the name is changed as ALM, Application Lifecycle Management. Application Lifecycle Management, ALM. From 11.0 version. It is a web-based application with a client-server architecture. That means here, it looks like web-based application, works like web-based application, but internal architecture will be Windows-based application. This is one of the drawbacks we have in the Quality Center. Because of that, even though we have the option to derive the test cases in the Quality Center, where we are not going to prefer to write the test cases into the Quality Center. Even though they give an option to you to write the test cases. But that is not the major intention to derive the test case of the Quality Center. Quality Center is to execute your test cases and you go for the defect reporting. That's the major intention of the Quality Center. Because of that, they give an option to you. You write test cases in Excel sheet. You write test cases in Excel sheet. By following simple steps, you can export your test cases into the Quality Center. By following simple steps, you can export your test cases from the Excel sheet to Quality Center. Because more users are accessing Quality Center to derive the test cases, so due to client-server architecture, it will not go and give the quick response to you. That's a drawback. So because of the test cases preparation, you can do in the Excel sheet, but execution you can do from the quality center. But execution, whenever you identify defects, straight away you can go for the defect reporting. As it is a HP product, so what are the other tools are there for the HP? Other products for HP? QTP is a HP product or not? Loader is also a HP product. Winner is also a HP product. As quality center is a HP product, they given connections to the QTP, LoadRunner and WinRunner. You can connect. What about Selenium? Definitely, they won't give the permission for the QC to Selenium because Selenium is the competitor for the HP. They won't give that. They won't encourage like that. First of all, business point of, there is no connection Selenium to the QC. So manual testing time, you can use it. So you can execute test case individually using Selenium. You are going to analyze the result. So those defects you can report through quality center. Okay. So quality, you can report defect report to the quality center. There is one form, you fill it and you can send to the defects, the quality center. But there is no connection between QC to the Selenium. Now, what type of database technologies it supports? It supports MS SQL by default, then Oracle. This type of technology is going to support. By default, MS SQL is going to support. So now, what is the purpose of the quality center? Why do you prefer quality center? What are the activities you can do in quality center? The quality center is responsible for the following activities, like it works as a repository. I said, we have database. You can maintain the test cases. You can maintain the HP tools automation scripts, not Selenium automation scripts. Okay? The automation scripts means, don't think that it's a Selenium. So only HP related tools automation scripts, QTP scripts, LoadRunner scripts, WinRunner scripts, you can maintain in our quality center. Works as a repository which is used to store user requirements. User requirements are nothing but scenarios. What are the functionalities out there? In a hierarchy, you can maintain the your requirement state. You can maintain the manual test cases, automation test scripts, HP tools, automation scripts. Test results, once execution completed, by default, result is going to maintain. Either it can be manual, either it can be automation. Automation script result also is going to maintain. Defects, then automation tester resource files. When I'm going to work with QTP, we are going to create the different resource files like shared repository files, library functions, recovery scenarios. The QTP resource files are available, those we can store in our quality center. Now the responsibilities of the what we can do in the quality center first point. Works as a repository which is used to store user requirements, manual test cases and automation test scripts, test results, defects, automation, test resource files. The second thing, test management activities like performing traceability matrix, test execution and test analysis. So what is the traceability matrix? What is that traceability matter? What is the use of that? Requirements traceability matrix. How do you know that all the requirements are covered or not with written test cases? And are three, four questions are important during testing. One is retesting. Second one, regression testing. Third one is requirements traceability matrix. Fourth one is reproducible defect. So that we can do here. Traceability matrix means to analyze all the requirements are covered or not with written test cases. We discussed during manual testing, login test case once I prepared like this. We went into sheet 3. How many, what are the scenarios are there? But those scenarios, what are the test cases we derived? We mapped like this to analyze all the scenarios are covered or not with written test cases. This is what the requirements traceability matrix. to analyze the gap between test cases to the requirements, we go over requirements traceability matrix. This one you can prepare in Excel sheet or in a quality center. That's what I'm saying that. So test management activities like performing traceability matrix, test execution and test analysis. How much portion is covered? How many test cases are passed? How many test cases need to execute? How many are failed? You can analyze easily. Easily it's going to generate the reports and the graphs to you, which you can use for the defect reporting purpose. Reporting tool, we can generate reports and the graphs for the requirements based on the present scenario, so test results and the defects. And also a defect tracking tool where we can store and track the defects. We can store defects information. At any point of time, you want to know that how many defects have the status as fixed. You can track easily. How many defects have the status as new? You can track easily. This is possible. So this is about the, what is the purpose? Why do you use quality center? What we can do in the quality center? Means this is thing. Now quality center is responsible for the following activities. One is works as a repository. These are all things we can store. We can perform test management activities. We can use as a reporting tool to generate the reports and the graphs. We can use as a defect tracking tool. These are the activities in quality center. This quality center like this, we have the various tools in the market. Like ClearQuest is there, Bugzilla, D-Tracker, PR Tracker, Issue Tracker, Jira. These are the various tools that are available. Jira, most of the cases, games software companies are going to use the Jira. Games software companies. Okay. So these are the free tools. Here, only ClearQuest is an IBM product, Quality Center is HP products. Remaining all the tools are free tool cities. Free tool cities. Okay. Our Quality Center coming with two modules. One is QC administration. Second one is Quality Center. One is QC administration, other one is Quality Center. There are two modules. Now as I said that it is a web-based application which is not installed in our local system. Quality Center is not installed at our environment in local systems. The Quality Center will be installed in the server. So they are going to provide the Quality Center URL to you to access the Quality Center. The URL will be given along with the test plan document and a test environment component. In test plan document and a test environment component, we are going to get the what is the URL of the quality center. Which domain you have to work, which project you need to work. This type of information are going to get. Now, let me show that what are the two modules are there. Whenever you want to open the Quality Center, not Internet Explorer, not the Firefox browser. Now we have the IE browser, QC Explorer we are going to get. This is the browser which you have to use. QC Explorer browser. This browser you have to use. Then, it's not going to load that much fast. It will take some time for us. Okay. Now see, these are the two modules which you have in the Quality Center. What is the first one? Quality Center Administration. What is the next one here? Quality Center. Can you tell which module are you going to involve? Quality Center module or Quality Center Administration module? So we are going to involve into the Quality Center Administration module. Sorry, Quality Center module. Here administrator is going to involve. Now if I want to log into this application, so when I want to use this one, first you're asking that. You have to give the So valid username password values. Is there possibility to create your username password values here? No, you can't create it. Those has to be created by the administrator. Maybe your company got the new project. The project has to be created in the quality center, not by you. Your administrator has to create. In your company, there may be 30 testers are working for the various projects. All the testers should not have the permission for all the projects to access in the quality center. So 10 testing for one project, 10 testing for other projects. That permission has to be given by the administrator. New employees are joined as a tester in your company. They may not created in the quality center to access. Your administrator has to create the new employees. And he has to change the privileges for the users. Somebody may work as a project administrator. Somebody may work as a developer. Someone has to work as a testing unit. These are the permissions has to be provided by the administrator. Once he done these activities, then your quality center administrator is going to give the information to you with your login credentials. Which domain, which project you need to work. After getting that mail, then we are going to work into the quality center. Okay. Now, first I will explain about the quality center administration module. Then we go for the quality center module. But here, remember, you are not the responsible, you are not the authorized person to work on the quality center administration module in the company. Just to get some idea, I am going to show in the class. Okay. They won't give the permission to you to work in the quality center administration module. Okay. How he is going to perform our activities, his activities. I will close this one, quality center. Now see my here. If I go for QC administration, who is responsible for this? QC admin is the responsible. Administrator is the responsible. What are the activities he is going to perform? He will go into creating the domains. He can creating the projects. He can able to create the new users to access the quality center. He can assign users for a project. There are the four types of activities he is going to perform. I'm taking an example here. I got a new project in my company. So related to the banking domain, the project name is HDFC Bank. Users are, these are the users are there. In that, one as a project administrator, two person has to work as a test engineer. The other person has to work as a developer. Different type of users are working for the same project. Okay. Now this all the users I need to create in quality center as an administrator, and I need to give the privileges for these users. I need to assign the users for the projects. These are the activities. How we can do that? As a QC administrator, which I have the trial version. In the trial version, so user name is what? Admin. The password is null. Now assuming that I am going to work as administrator now, not like faculty, not like Madhukar. So my name is, username is admin. So how I can go for these activities? Open QC Explorer as an administrator. Go for the SA bin. So here, localhost 8080 SA bin is there. Why localhost is there? Because the quality center which I am showing to you, it is not installed in server, which is installed in my local system. In my laptop only it is installed. That's why localhost is there. Otherwise server name we have to give there. Which server it is installed. Okay. Then click on go. So admin, password is null. Click on login. Like this, we are going to get it. Now, what are the activities administrator I want to do here? I want to create the domains. I want to create the project. I want to create the users. I want to assign users for project. Now here I'm taking domain, banking domain I want to create. When I open this quality center here, it's showing the site project, showing that under that some default is there. Is there banking project, banking domain is there? No. So newly installed, no domains are created. Now I want to create the domain. It's not that much difficult. There is a create domain. Click this one. Domain name. So banking. Click on OK. So domain is created. Now what I need to do after that, I need to create the project, HDFC Bank. Maybe you can create like this for multiple domains. Another domain I want to create. Insurance. Finance, like this. Different domains you can create. Now I want to create the project. Under which domain I want to create? The HDFC Bank. Banking. You can select it. Then go to the create project. It is asking that, do you want to create an empty project? Yes, it is. Click on next. Enter the project name. HDFC Bank. Maybe you are not selected domain earlier. Now you can select under which domain do you want to create the project. Click on next. Database type, Oracle, MS SQL. Which one do you want to use? I want to go for the default one, MS SQL. There is no Oracle installed in my system. With that, it is going to be enabled here. So click on next. Just warning message, skip this one. Now it's showing the list of users, already existing users in your quality center, it's showing that. Other different list of users are there. Do you want to add any one user as project administrator? Now as per my requirements here, the Madhukar has to work as a project administrator. His name is available, you can select, you can add into the list. Okay? But that name person is not available here, not yet created. New user. So that's the reason saying that you can also assign your project administrator after creating a project. Later also you can do this activity. It's saying that. Okay. Go to next. Now about to create the new project, showing the project name HDFC Bank, on domain banking server local host. Click on create. Now what is giving that? Project HDFC Bank created successfully. Now database project means set of tables. Tables were not created. We assign these all the project, these tables for the HDFC Bank project. Whatever information we are going to maintain for our project, those are going to be stored in these tables. Now see that already existing table database, if I go like default one is there, projects, quality center demo is there. If I go to that one, there you have the bug table is there. If I select it, it shows the list of bugs which are already identified for that project. Now here bug ID, bug status, responsible who identified, project, subject, summary, description, about the bug, so comments, reproducible or not, bug severity, priority, detected by testing enmities. So lot of information it is going to, version, which version identified or which date is identified, mailed or not, like this information is going to. Now I have the various status like fixed, reopen, open, closed. Now you can write SQL statement here related to the required information. I want to go for that bg underscore status as open. How many bugs are there which status as open? You can write SQL statement there. When you click on execute SQL, the how many defects are there with the status as open list of status. That is a easy way they can track. I want to know that specific testing in it, how many defects are identified. Directed by is there. So Michael, how many defects identified? I can go for that SQL statement. When you click on execute SQL, the result are going to get. So that easily you can track it. Okay. So creating domain, you know, we got creating project. Now what next I need to do? Creating users. How I can do that one? So go to site users, click on new user icon. So users I am creating, Madhukar. So other information not mandatory, click on OK, but you can set the password. I'm giving as MindQ. Click on OK. OK. Again, new user. The username Rajesh. I go for Rajesh. OK. Password again. MindQ. Okay. Other username. So Rambo. I'm creating the users, but I'm not specifying the how it is role. I'm not specifying here. That option is not there here. Rambo also created. What next? I want to go. Raju. Any user? Raju. Okay. Password. Mind. Click on OK. Like this. So different users are there. Created. Now this users has to assign for the project or not. So if I am not assigned any project, what will happen? See, observe that. I go to the quality center, QC bin, go. I go for Rajesh is there, password also is there. Created user, click on authenticate. Now what is showing here? Because users are created, you are a valid user, but you don't have the permission to access any one of the project in your quality center to perform your activities. So that reason, so once they created users, they should assign it. How they can assign? Go to the site projects list. So go for them. For which project I want to assign users, select that project name. HDFC Bank. The right side you are going to find the project details about the HDFC Bank. There is a project users link is there. Go for this tab here. No users are assigned. Now there is a add user button. Click this one. It is asking that do you want to add the users from the list or other project users you want to copy. So I want to go for the add from the users list. So Rausu has to assign. Select the username, there is an arrow button, click this one. Ramu, Rajesh, Madhukar. That's enough. Now among these three users, one user I want to give permission as a project administrator, that is Madhukar, I am going to give that one. What about others? Here, Rajesh and Raju has to work as a QA tester. Quality assurance test engine. That means test engine. Ramu has to work as a developer. Those options are available? Not available. So whatever activity I shown, those only they can do here. If I want to change the some users permissions into developer or tester, so that has to be done by the now project administrator. Not by the administrator. That means as a Madhukar, he has to do that one. Because he is the administrator. For this HDFC Bank, he can do the privileges, he can change the privileges for the users. Now this is what the quality center administration task completed. Now he is going to send a mail to the project administrator. My task is completed. So these are your username, password, values. Now project administrator has to go for the changing the privileges. Let's see that note. By default, associated project members will get permission as read only. So read only. What is the meaning of that? If I go for the quality center, if I open QC bin as a Rajesh, I'm going to log in. Now I got the domain project because they given permission. But when I log in here, I can't do any work here because user type is not defined. By default, only read-only mode going to shows to you. The options are going to be here for us. Those are so disabled. You can't do anything here. Options are disabled. Read-only permission. So now your project administrator has to change the privileges for the users. How I can change? Now I'm going to, as a project administrator, so that has to be done in the QC module only. So I'm going to enter the my login credentials here. Now Seema, when I enter Madhukar, when I click on tab here, where my control is going? Where control is going? Here it is. Like go about like this going. So this is a defect or not? What type of defect? What type of category defect it is? Unfriendly behavior. Usability testing will discuss. User friendliness. This is the unfriendly behavior of the application we are going to go. Tab, when I click, control is not moving to the other component. Tab is going to the there, go about like that. Okay. So this type of defects you have to observe. Okay. Now mind queue. Click on authenticate. Domain banking. Project HDFC Bank. Go for login. Okay. Now here you're showing the domain, project, user. I want to customize the user permissions. Go to tools menu, customize, you select. Go to the project users. Now here, so Madhukar TD admin showing the TD means lower version name, test director. Still that marks are there. So Rajesh permission I want to change as a QA tester. Select the username. So select the member name, add him into that user list. So Raju also as a QA tester. Ramu has to work as a like developer. Now during security testing we discussed authentication, authorization. Now this is the type of user base. Now permissions are going to be changes. First, are you able to log in or not? So authentication. You have the permission to do that activity or not? Authorization. Authentication, authorization. Okay. Now after this I am going to save. Maybe I want to add some more users also. That is also possible to me as an administrator, project administrator for this particular project only. But I can't create the new users. I can add the new users for my project as a project administrator. Save, then return, log out. So now, so two persons activities where we discussed here. One is QC administrator, other one is project administrator activities also we discussed. Now after that, these activities are completed. Now they are going to send a mail like this. So login name, Rajesh. Password, MindCube. Which domain, banking. Rajesh, project is HDFC. Like the other users, they are going to send mail like this. Okay. So you are going to get the mail. Then we are going to work as a testing unit. How we are going to work? We are going to see that. Take 5 minutes break. I will continue it.